First of all, open up the command prompt and create a new virtual environment. Here I'm doing it in G drive test env folder, but you can always change the folder name to whatever you want. Now you can see a new virtual environment folder is created. Let's create a new folder to store our Python and Jupyterlab files. There we go. Okay, navigate to that newly created folder. And activate the virtual environment we just created. Usually, I'll upgrade pip. When you pip list, you should see all the packages available in your environment. Now we are going to pip install Jupyterlab. Let's get into the Jupyterlab interface. Here I'm starting a Python file. Which is this untitled.py, and it also appears in a folder we've just created. Hit F2, rename the untitled Python file, let's say test.py, and you should see the file name changes here as well. Go back to the main panel and try out a Jupyter notebook. Here I'm showing you the autocomplete feature on Jupyter Notebook. Inside a function, hit tab, and you'll see the available properties. Shift space, and you'll see the function description. Let's try the pathlibs path. Hit tab to view the function properties. Shift space to view function description. This feature doesn't exist when editing Python file in Jupyterlab. Let me show you in the Python file that the autocomplete doesn't work. I keep tapping the tab button and no function properties are shown. Okay, let's shut down Jupyterlab. Let's restart command prompt. Navigate to the Jupyterlab folder and activate the virtual environment. Now let's pip install the Jupyterlab LSV package. We also need the Jedi language server. All right, let's get into Jupyterlab. Still doesn't work. Let me see what happened. Let's go to the extension manager let's try installing this plugin. I don't have Node.js installed in this computer. Let me see. Shut down Jupyterlab first. Let's enable the Jupyter server extension. Let's try it again. Navigate to my Python file, try it out with a function, and function description comes out automatically. Hit tab and the available properties pop up. Okay, shut down Jupyterlab. Now we want to create a shortcut to initiate Jupyterlab, because starting Jupyterlab with command prompt is cumbersome, right? Simply open up your notepad and type out the cmd command this way. You notice it's just like what you did in command prompt, but replacing the enter key with an and sign. Check the path that holds the Jupyterlab files. Insert the command prompt to activate our virtual environment. And save it as a .bath file. You can name this .bath file whatever you want. On your desktop, create a shortcut and point to the location of the .bath file we just created. Right-click the shortcut icon, Properties, and define the hotkeys that you want to start Jupyterlab. Apply. Now try the hotkey sequence we already defined, and it will initiate Jupyterlab. Now you can start coding Python with the code completion features. Alright, let me close Jupyterlab and deactivate the environment. That's it. Hope it helps.